When Sally left the homestead, she was only 9 years old. Her folks had just lost everything. What wasn't lost got sold in a 24-foot river skiff, hungry to the bone. They set out across the biggest lake into the great unknown. That's how it was. They were portaged across the mountains by an ancient Chevy truck, held together with string and wire. The engine ran on luck. The kids rode in the trailer, singing songs back in the skiff. Except those times when the outer wheels rolled out over a cliff. That's when you walked.
I wish that I could go back to the hills that I knew then, on the shores of Iliamna, throwing sticks into the wind. Wake up in the morning and hear my mother say,
get out of bed, you sleepy heads. How you gonna sleep all day? Doesn't work that way. On the other side of the mountains, the barge they were to meet didn't show for seven tides. The rain came down in sheets. On the west side of Cooking Lead, they wintered in a plywood shack and watched the seals upon the ice float up the bay and back. That's how it was.
I wish that I could go back to the hills that I knew then, on the shores of Iliamna, throwing sticks into the wind. Wake up in the morning and hear my father say,
it's breakfast time in Alaska and the ice is on the bay. But it doesn't work that way. Now Sally works the news desk at the local radio. I'll stop in to see her. We talk of long ago. She gets staring out the window, miles and miles away, back across those mountains of Iliamna Bay. Doesn't have to say, ¶¶ hardest times, but the memories still endure. In my heart, we're all together there, as rich as we were poor. On the Iliamna shore,